Hello, friends. Let me ask you a question first. What would you call someone who spends most of their life serving others? Well, in today's world, he would be called crazy, as nowadays, most of us are concerned with our success and gains. It's extremely hard to find someone who's as kind as this 70-year-old man. He spent 30 years digging a 5-kilometer canal to bring water to his village, and ended up being the perfect example of selflessness. Kothilwa village, the home of Laungi, is surrounded by thick forests and mountains, and is marked as a shelter for the Maoists. Since this place is situated at a low level, it was subject to water overflow during rainy season. Water was not the only cause of problems for the villagers. The residents lived in poverty. People didn't have enough money to meet basic needs, including food, clothing, and shelter. The houses in his village were simple and didn't have enough space for the animals. Therefore, they were mostly outside without any shelter. The water from surrounding hills was a cause of extreme worry for the villagers, since it was a potential threat to their livestock and farms. Laungi was not like the others. He couldn't sit and wait for something miraculous to happen. Rather, he took the situation in his hands, made a plan, and got on his feet to make it happen. He couldn't allow the destruction of his farms and animals by the overflowing water, since it was the only means of earning for the residents. He knew that the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step, so Laungi decided to execute his plan and to bring his dream into reality. He took his cattle and simple tools along with him and started digging, without looking back. He worked day and night, even during extremely hot weather, and only went home to eat and sleep. Not only this, he never wore a shirt while working and got severe sunburn. He was a truly selfless man. Initially, he met heavy criticism from the people. They even called him a madman. Even his family didn't support him and called him crazy. Nobody offered him a hand. He asked villagers for help, but they refused to do it. Finally, though, his efforts were paid at last, and he ended up digging a canal that's 4 feet wide and 3 feet deep. Amazing, right? He worked alone constantly and persistently for the benefit of his fellow citizens for 30 long years. It's true that small steps indeed make big changes. And what's even more surprising is that he used traditional tools to carve the canal. Yes, you heard it right. He didn't take help from big machinery and modern tools. He used basic tools that any laborer has at their disposal. He is truly the king of engineers. Make sure you watch this video until the end, because I'm going to tell you what happened to influence him to take this job on by himself. And believe me, you don't want to miss that. Here is the leader of his village talking about Laungi's selfless effort. He decided to dig a canal from a natural water source in. The villagers took their cattle generally to that source for watering, which also provided food to the animals living in the forest area. He knew that the water source was enough to irrigate the farmland of the villagers. However, it was a great challenge to bring water into the village. He surveyed the land and decided on the canal route. After working constantly for 30 years, he managed to dig the canal that is 4 feet wide and 3 feet deep. The villagers called him mad when he went daily to dig the canal with traditional digging equipment. Because of his efforts, the district administration also came forward with aid. The administration has now named it Laungi Canal. He also dug a small pond to store water in the summers for irrigation and domestic consumption. Laungi is a true example of hard work and dedication. The amount of effort, patience, focus, and commitment to keep going until he reached his goal is unbelievable. His mind and soul were strong to achieve what he dreamed of. He put his blood, sweat, and tears into this project for the benefit of his homeland and the ones living there. Let me move on to what motivated him to take on this laborious task. He was hurt by the relocation of young adults from his village, who were in search of a better living and job opportunities. since the only type of work offered by their hometown was farming or animal husbandry. Even his children left and moved to the big city. As we know, youth is the hope of the future. And that hope was diminishing from the drought-prone village of Laungi. The only population left behind were women, children, and mostly older people. He was extremely unhappy with the situation, and therefore took up this noble task upon his shoulders. While addressing his unbelievable creation, Laungi said to the media, "It took me 30 years to dig this canal, which takes the water to a pond in the village. I did it on my own without anyone's help for the last 30 years. I would go to the nearby jungle with my cattle and dig out the canal. No one joined me in this journey. Villagers are going to cities to earn a livelihood, but I decided to stay back." This man is truly remarkable in the history of mankind. A local from the village, while talking to the media, said, "He has been carving out the canal for the last 30 years, single-handedly. This will benefit a large number of animals and irrigate the fields as well. He is not doing it for his benefit, but the entire area." That's great to see that his fellow men are commending him for his spectacular work. Not only this, a teacher from the village also praised him and said, "A lot of people will benefit here. People are now getting to know him because of his work." Not only from his village, Laungi received appreciation throughout the country for his dedication. People called him a superhuman. One user on Twitter said, "Salute to this man's dedication and hard work towards water conservation. You should call him a one-man army." That's it, guys. Our inspirational story ends here. Before going anywhere, please make sure to hit that subscribe button and leave a comment down below saying, "I subscribed," and we'll try our best to reply to your comments. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time.